And we are live. Welcome to the Resistance.
Expect me. Welcome to the Resistance.
Spitfire Sentinel. I'm about to bring this rap game to another level. I'm rapping for God, I ain't rapping for the devil. I'm bringing the game in the name of a rebel. I don't rap about guns, thugs, drugs, or how I'm trying to catch a buzz. I'm here to speak the truth and not any lies, cause I'll always be on the lower side. And I know Satan's always trying to test me, but I'm in the game until the day they arrest me. For speaking the truth about the deception they're selling, I'm not a fake and I'm not a felon, I'm just me. I speak my mind freely. I'm tired of being programmed by the TV. The world is a joke, but between you and me, my chain is broken, so now you can't see clearly. Took the red pill, now I'm offering it to you. Once you take it, you'll stop seeing truth. This is what I'm called to do. I wish this world could see right through, but they don't. And I can tell you why. It's cause you are following the master of lies. Give them fame and fortune, all that bling. Give them fat stacks of cash, even if they can't sing. But it ain't worth it in my eyes, cause I can see clearly, rise above all the half-truths being spread to our youth. The deception can be hard to see through. This ain't an opinion, this ain't a theory, this is truth. I hope you can't hear me, can you hear me? Do you want the truth? I'll bring it. Do you want the truth? I'll take it. Do you want the truth? I'll bring it. Yes, I want the truth. I'll take it. Do you want the truth? I'll bring it. Yes, I want the truth. I'll take it. Do you want the truth? I'll bring it. Do you want the truth? I'll take it. What's going on in the world today? All these rap videos leading our babies astray. Leading our babies away from the truth and light. Rappers influence them to do things that ain't right. I'm on the mic talking about cane and guns. But it's really time to do it, guaranteed you'll run. Non-stop talk about a trifling life. Filled with alcohol and drugs, another man's wife. Costume menage a trois, random chicks. Now it's at the local health clinic feeling sick. Got something that you couldn't throw back. Play the Mac, the devil got you like that. What does it take to profit a man to lose his soul? And gain the whole world, gain the silver and gold. One day you must see the Lord's faces. Will he say well done or will he look in disgraces? Without faith it's impossible to please. So please drop down on your motherfucking knees. And beg, please have mercy on me, my Lord, one accord. You want the truth? Okay, I'm bringing it here. Repent everyone because the kingdom of heaven is near. The enemy roams around. For who he may devour, stay connected to your Lord and stay. Your true power. Do you want it? One more time. Do you want the truth? I'll bring it. Yes, I want the truth. I'll take it. Do you want the truth? I'll bring it. Yes, I want the truth. I'll take it. Do you want the truth? I'll bring it. Yes, I want the truth. I'll take it. Do you want the truth? I'll bring it. Yes, I want the truth. I'll take it. Do you want the truth? If you want the truth, I'll bring it. Yes, I want the truth. Yes, I want the truth. I'll take it.
Welcome. Gotta update that with a new book. All right, all right, all right.
Yeah.
welcome everyone, and I'm passing to Lori.
Welcome everybody to Rise of the New World Order. Tonight we have on with us Jeff Hayes, Eric Wilkinson, and myself. If you are in the live chat, we do ask you to be family friendly. We will be moderators in there. If you're new to the channel, welcome. Take a minute to hit that subscribe button, hit that bell so you know when we go live. What's up, guys?
What's up, what's up?
What's up, what's up?
What's up, what's up? What's going on with you, Jeff?
So sounds like Spitfire. You got your books, Lori. You should get your books any day now. And this is the only place to get them because Amazon's not carrying it right now.
We got new books.
So hopefully, Amazon picks it up. But oh, you did get them. Look at that.
Yo, man. Yo, yo, come here, man.
We got your books.
You need some books, Maggie.
I got your books. So many books.
Oh, look at those books.
And they are here.
That's the new artist, too, right there. The new cover guy.
Not bad at all. Yeah. I'm liking the new art. Flag. I mean, you know, it's...
That was his concept. I just ran out. We're just trying to get kicked out there, but...
No one can replace
the shadowy figure. No, nobody.
Yeah, nobody can
replace there's that Latin again.
There's that Latin again.
There will be a translation within the next 2 weeks.
Yeah. And I want to remind everybody in the chat room, Sarah's book has not gone out yet. Christian's book has not gone out yet. I think Pixie's hasn't gone out yet, and Melinda's hasn't. So I've got four that are going to go out just as soon as I can. So those four will go out. I got to write it down again. Melinda.
And of course, tonight, as always, a lucky winner will be receiving a book. Brand new one.
We'll have to figure out how we're going to give it away tonight. I think just about everybody in the chat room has one so far. I'm looking through.
Yeah, and maybe spend some time tonight. This is urgent status reports 1 through 5. So kind of going through 1 through 5. And I have them already. I had them. I got the cleeps. I had them early. From Jeff, so maybe kind of get a synopsis of what's going on in each status update 1 through 5 that's in this book, too, because this is current stuff, folks.
I got them, too.
Bueller? Oh, I'm still, why am I just on camera? So there we go. Here you go.
Where did you send me those updates? I'm trying to remember what email address you used.
Who, me?
Search for,
Jeff sent them to me.
Jeff sent them to me. That's right.
I got them all. Yeah.
Search for Samaritan Sentinel.
Oh, Samaritan.
Or GMT8 at SamaritanSentinel.com.
PMT.
JMTH, or just by, they're my initials.
And I also have, so this is 1 through 5. I also have status update 6. Did anything from 6 make it in the book?
No, that was way too. That was over 100 pages. Yeah. It's if you get over 250 pages, it starts getting almost too expensive in the conspiracy realm or whatever to kick out a book. That's where the problem was with my first book, I think. But I mean, as short as I could, but still tell you the whole story. But I mean, seriously, it could have been a 10,000 page book, right?
Oh, I see that status update 6 is 83 pages alone. This one didn't make it. I remember we kept talking, I'm like, dude, if you keep waiting, because you kind of want to keep waiting because something new, something groundbreaking came up every fucking time.
I kept writing. I know, I had so many notes.
Well, yeah. The 6 would get us an instant strike talking about most of the stuff in it. We'd have to really
pretty quick. Really go next week or two, the life insurance company They're going to start announcing their first quarter results. So this should be pretty interesting, because I bet the last time they did a quarterly update, they're like, we have like 40% extra deaths going on and we don't know what's going on. And so I would postulate that that percentage would be increasing. And I have heard already that it's increasing. So we're going to be,
our so next couple of weeks should agent. Be.
Yeah.
Our insurance agent contacted us last year. Dave and him are actually friends on Facebook, but he sent Dave a text message. And he said, you and your wife are not going to take that thing we don't talk about, right? And Dave was like, absolutely not. He goes, because I'm going to tell you right now that if you do and you die, they're not going to pay out the premiums.
Mm.
That's what he told us for our insurance company.
What you talking about, Willis?
That's for our insurance company. I don't know about anybody else's, but I know for ours, that's what he was advising his clients. You know, he's saying that they're not going to pay it out. Because I guess there's in some insurance policies, there's a clause that says that if you take anything, what is it called?
Experimenting with drugs.
Experimental, yeah, anything experimental that hasn't been approved, that it nullifies your policy.
I can totally see that.
Yeah.
And we're even looking at what if you take an experimental jibber jabber, you might not even qualify under the Constitution of the United States of America anymore as human.
Yep.
That's what you find out over here.
And you know what's interesting about that, Eric, was the date that came out. That came out long before it was even, you know, I was going to say long before it was contemplated, but obviously if they put that out, they've had this in place and this plan done for quite a while. But I mean, it was just when I sent that to you, the date on it really was what opened up my eyes. I was like, wow, this is how long they've been planning this out.
Right. Yeah. Right. Well, speaking of that, I'm signed up for the World Economic Forum. So I got a couple of emails in the last couple of days about the World Economic Forum.
Awesome.
In order to see the juicy stuff, you got to sign up. Awesome. And now cue the rumors that I am part of the Illuminati because I signed up for the World Economic Forum.
Do you get the nifty Klaus outfit? Klaus Schwab outfit?
I wasn't a bonus plus member. Not yet. That costs a million.
Can we start a GoFundMe for that? Maybe we can, you know, help you out here.
That's a great idea. I love that.
We'll get you that premium package. You get the Klaus Schwab nifty little outfit. And when the mothership comes, I think you get the chance to go first.
And they'll throw in the Bill Gates stilts on the next level. You can have your very own clone of Elon Musk if he is indeed not already a clone, but I digressed. Let's talk. So starting out with volume one,
he's like our age, isn't that scary? He's like 52 or something, or 53, isn't he? If that,
he might be your age, not my age. I'm only I'm 50, so I'm I ain't 53.
I'm only 29, so I don't know what you're talking about.
I think he's 51.
Something. Question is there a large celebration when someone reaches 69?
He's actually only
I thought it's for senior citizens. Okay.
He was born in 1971.
Oh, wow.
So volume one, Jeff, can you give us kind of just a synopsis of what's contained in volume one?
So volume.
Well, let me get to my book here and crack it up. Well, basically, volume one is me panicking.
No cliff notes allowed.
At the start of the pandemic, I was just like, oh, this isn't good. This is a huge false flag. And so I was just like, I need to grab an alarm bell and start ringing it. So this is it right here. The first update is the alarm bell. Me just going for it. Ding, 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 ding. wake the F up. This is a false flag. So and then going forward from that, I just tracked it the best I could through all the people I know on social media, basically, and put everything I found out in the updates as I found that out. So it's kind of a five update game calling of the pandemic from a conspiratorial point of view, I reckon.
Is this how call it all right down the line? Is this how the book starts? This is status update number one that's on the screen right now. Is this how you started it?
I can't read that on that screen for some reason.
Well, friend, this is not how I wanted us to meet again.
Yes, that's it, man. That's how I was. I was just like, I thought I had time to put out a third book and do all this stuff, and I was like, no, they're going for it right now, man. They are bringing the New World Order in right freaking now. So I was like, okay. So I just,
how's that?
Bring it. So yeah. That looks way better. Yep.
Well, friend, this is not how I wanted for us to meet again. I thought we had more time, but things are moving quickly now. As we descend into chaos, I'm going to try and turn these reports out as often as possible. Thus, we have a book now, as often as justified. Please look for, is this how you introed your book? The same thing that's written here?
Well, so the paperback that you got, and I've got, it's just basically the first five reports, just as you're reading it right now. It's just the five reports blocked together. I didn't go through and meld them together. It's just five individual reports, all in this book, is basically what it is. It's basically putting what I put out in the ebook over the last couple of years into paper. So when they hit the button and all the electricity goes away, at least these paperbacks will be floating around and people will be like, right, oh, this is what's going on. The end.
Well, in update number one, you know what? I can make it even bigger because our faces are on there. But in update number one, what stuck out to me, was things that anyone can relate to. You don't even have to be so-called conspiracy minded to understand some of this stuff. But yeah, please look for me on Facebook. Yeah. I got two pages going now as I'm bounced in and out of Facebook jail because I'm trying to wake people up and keep them updated. These are largely NWO themed meme and news pages, but I post links for pertinent other stuff also. Search for Samaritan Sentinel and Rise of the New World Order, the calling of man's meme machine. If I'm not actively posting there, that means I'm in Facebook jail or worse.
A meme machine.
Did you start the book with us right here? Because this is from update number one.
Oh, that's just, it's just page one of the first update. But yeah. I mean, I put like an intro page to the paperback, just saying, sure, hey, here's what's going on.
Are these updates you gave me, are they pretty much spot on to how you wrote the book, what you put in the book?
Exactly. No, I took the updates and flipped them over into this, sent them off to the formatter, and they just put it all together. But no, they're exactly unedited. Some of the stuff I said didn't come true. I'm still waiting on the big Pacific Cascadia earthquake, which I still would not doubt would go off in the next few years.
Mm-hmm.
Which would be horror. The whole fucking, sorry about my language. The whole freaking West Coast.
Well, we're on YouTube. You can say whatever you want.
I don't wait. Oh, who knows?
Yeah.
But that's about the only thing I got wrong, I think, actually. I was calling for mandatory vaccinations in that first.
There goes our strikes. You got to call them vaccinations.
Or
hippity hoppers. Yep. Seriously,
mandatory vaccination.
That's how bad it's gotten, right?
Oh no!
I'm sure I'll screw it up many times tonight, but yep, there's an algorithm for how many times we use those words now. That's where we're at, and that's what this book's all about, folks. Lori, you wanna read the next
one? That's why I'm wondering if Amazon's even gonna carry it because they haven't put it on their site yet. So I think they get the paper back.
They haven't.
They can delete the paperbacks once they're out there. They can delete all the ebooks. So,
well, you had said they haven't, but I mean, that's going to happen soon, right? Or are you going to be on the banned book list? They're going to burn the book?
Oh, I would probably be at the top of it, I would imagine. Who knows?
Probably. So I just put the link to Jeff's page for Facebook in the chat room. If you guys are interested in going over there and supporting the page, by all means. You want me to finish reading this?
Yeah, I was just, I thought maybe we'd just do the introduction part and then kind of take a synopsis of what's in part one.
I just feel like I needed to say something about the current events to the people who read my books and woke up. This is the way to search a ton. This is the way to reach a ton of people, and hopefully Amazon will alert you to my update here. I put this out on Amazon Kindle for as cheap as they would let me, $2.99. Hopefully Amazon will contact you about this update. You've got to prepare for the financial implosion that will be blamed on this thing we're not supposed to talk about, but it's really a thing we're not supposed to talk about. I'll also try to put this out on my Facebook pages, but it's pretty long for the Facebook post. I'll definitely try though. I certainly do appreciate people purchasing my book and spreading them around to support me and my family right now, as always. Thank you in advance for your continued support. There's no other book I know of that covers all the bases of the New World Order like my first one. The
following, I think we'd all agree, huh? I think we'd all agree on that.
I think that's all something we can agree on. The following should be taken under advisement as my opinion only, and it is up to you to do your own due diligence in looking into and tracking everything I'm going to say. I don't know for sure what's going to happen, but just look at financial gut shot from the alleged thing we're not supposed to talk about and effectively bankrupted the entire United
States. Can we not say that word anymore either?
No.
Is that a strike word now? It is?
Yeah.
Oh, good God.
The entire United States and even global travel industries of airlines, hotels, and restaurants. These businesses might never come back. Why would they? To go broke next year over the next thing we're not supposed to talk about. This is a gaping hole in our economy with millions now immediately on the unemployment ranks with not much future getting back into the same line of work because of those businesses are folding as you read this. You are witnessing the controlled demolition of our economy, our country, the United States right now, right before our eyes, while we are all detained in soft martial law for our own good against that thing that will kill less people than the flu.
The kung fu.
The kung fu fight.
Oh, no. Before we go there, I hope somebody, whoever your editor was, caught that one.
Yes, planned. It's a planned thing we're not supposed to talk about. It's, you know.
As long as he took one of the ends out. No, I'm just playing. So, but this intro is so, I mean, freaking perfect. Mm-hmm. And we're trying to read through it. And like, here we go. Are we allowed to say that word?
No.
Okay, God, I'm blown away. I'm touched and I'm freaking just very, very humbled to
Elon needs to buy YouTube.
Right, to have met Jeff Hayes and to have been a part of what he's trying to spend right now, which is something so, so big. Okay, go ahead, Lori.
It'll go off one of these days.
I just want to say something. There's people out there that deny. I mean, they look at the world, they look at people like us, and they call us conspiracy theorists. They call us derogatory. Yeah, conspirators. I mean, and they laugh at us and they mock us. Let me tell you something. They did that with the protocols of the learned elders of Zion too. They did that with the secret covenant. They did that with the Bible. You know, they do these things. They mock and ridicule what they're scared of, mm-hmm. not what they don't understand, but what they're scared of. And let me just say that it's hard to sit back and actually mock and ridicule something when it's coming to fruition in front of our faces.
Right.
The protocols of the learned elders of Zion back, a Brussels court deemed them a fake and a fraud.
Yep.
Yeah. But yet answer me a question. If that's the case, then why are all the protocols coming to fruition?
Every single one of them. Yep.
The same with the secret covenant. You sit there and you mock it and ridicule it. Oh my God, they believe in chemtrails, yet everything's coming to fruition. So, and the same with the Bible. You know, you don't have to believe the Bible. You don't have to believe it. just understand that the people that are in charge of this planet right now in this realm, they believe it enough to use it as their playbook. So when you get a book like Jeff's and you have all this information at your fingertips, literally, all you have to do is if you're looking at something, you know, you just looking at the table of contents alone in this book, you got to understand that every single one of those things is part of our reality right now. You know, so that's why these books, that's why us as a group, you know, and when I say us, I mean the people that put this information out there, not just Jeff, not just Eric, but everybody who does this, are considered crackpots at this point.
Not just CNN, not just Fox.
Right.
You know, I mean, no more than that.
You can deny it all you want, but as you're reading through Jeff's, just the introduction of his book alone should raise some flags in your psyche going, wow, you know.
You said the magic word, by the way. You used the chemtrail word, the geoengineering thing, and it's just interesting. The only clip I had ready to go for the show tonight was about exactly that. And because cameras are getting so much more high def, it's so much easier for your average person to take some great footage of these contrails. Wink, wink.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, play a little bit of this, then we'll go back to the book.
April 24th, 2022. Not the first day of solar spring.
Look at that. No markings on that plane.
Nope. Notice that? Isn't that interesting? No markings on the plane.
No marking, no call sign, nothing.
Which, according to international air codes, you have to have markings on the plane.
Mm-hmm.
But go ahead.
Mm-hmm.
They probably blotted them out. See that? Isn't that insane? No markings on the plane. I'm glad you freaking.
Is there windows? Was there windows on that plane?
I was going to bring that up and you already saw it. That's
what the crap?
Hey.
Is it even real? I mean, you know what I mean?
No windows on the plane, folks. Can't make this shit up. Look at it.
So obviously it's not a passenger.
What type of plane is this?
It's not, obviously, it's not a
passenger. What could it contain? They have no windows.
They don't need windows. There's no people on it.
Right. Ding, ding, ding.
No.
There you go. It's even, it appears to have a heartbeat, folks.
People can sit there and argue all they want about it. It's contrails, it's moisture in the atmosphere, blah, 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 blah.
It's impossible.
Let me tell you something. I live in the flight path some days. It depends on how the wind is here. But I live in the flight path of Midway Airport. Literally, I wash my dishes and I could see the shadow of a plane going across my backyard. Okay. So I'm well aware of the flight paths in and around Chicago. If you look up there on a day that they've sprayed, let's put the chemicals aside. But we have a bigger problem then, because now we've got a bunch of drunk pilots in the air because have you seen some of the, I mean, literally crisscrossing each other, you know, little S's. And I mean, literally, guys.
Well, here's the bottom line on that. Almost all modern planes use high turbo bypass engines now, which do not create any contrails. But end of story. So why are they still calling them contrails? Well, other planes, there's older planes that do. Yeah, but
that's not what we're looking at.
Right. Mm-hmm. Older planes, right? Ones that are flown privately or ones that are independently owned. Not like this. And there's no markings. And again, I'm going to say it one more time. If you want to shut down someone who says they're contrails, simply tell them that most, if not all, planes now use high turbo bypass engines, which, if you look it up, don't believe me, look it up, produce no contrails. So how, where is all this coming from in our sky if that's true? Which it is. Don't believe me, though. Look it up. Exactly. But I will say it's true.
In the chat room, they don't do, they've done psychological tests on the people that fly these. They have no remorse of what they are doing. They even have a code name.
The planes can't even create what they say they're creating because the engines they use don't create this.
Yeah.
Even if they did, even the older ones wouldn't create something this large.
Mm-hmm. Well, not only that, like, but this, what's the difference? What's the difference between, but let's think logically. Contrails is moisture, which means that once they spread out, they're just going to dissipate. They're going to,
well, even if they did create contrails, because 5 to 8 seconds, they'd be gone.
Right. Because the water molecules are small. Okay, and then they would dissipate, making them smaller until they disappear.
Like when you see your breath on a very, very cold day, it's that's not the same concept.
Here. These things fly over, and a half an hour later, they have spread into gray muck.
You see this? That's some really good. I remember I used to go out and do that, freaking just catch them as they were going and spreading out, and then I slowly realized nobody freaking cared. Look at that. Yeah. This was impressive. And again, so if you want to say these are contrails, number one, high turbo bypass engines jets use now are incapable of producing a contrail, let alone something like this.
Yeah.
Number two, even if it was a contrail, it'd be gone in 5 to 8 seconds.
Yep.
Any questions? This is your brain. This is your brain on the jibby jabber.
Yep.
Any questions?
Now the next question is,
wow.
But now you have to ask yourself, why are they doing this? I have my theory. I know you have your theory. My theory is that they are geoengineering the atmosphere, or what did I call it? Terraforming the atmosphere. Yeah. To support a different life source.
Sure. Big part of it. Been killing a bunch of people in the process.
And killing a bunch of people.
Perfect. You see this here?
The first time, have you ever seen a chem bomb? I think we talked about this one time.
A chem bomb.
I was living in Phoenix. It was in 2013. And I had just started discussing chemtrails with my then husband. And it was funny because he would call me on his phone, and he was a mobile car mechanic. He had a van and he went out to people's houses or on the freeway, wherever they needed him. So he was all over the valley, and he would call me and he'd be like, Lori, I'm looking at the sky. You are so right. There's something wrong, you know? So I went outside one day at our apartment complex, and I'm talking Phoenix, Arizona in like June. Okay. It's hotter than blazes out there. And I'm looking up at the sky, and for about 4 or 5 days before that, we had these, they were kind of like cobwebs, kind of sticky, cobwebby, white kind of stuff that were on our vehicles. But
you got the good ones.
But in Arizona, it wasn't the monsoon season, so it didn't come from the rain, you know? So I went outside one day, it was in the afternoon, like 2 o'clock in the afternoon, and I was kind of looking up, trying to see if I could catch any, you know, the planes and stuff. And I saw these things like catching the reflection, like metal up in the atmosphere, up in the sky. And it would hit it just right, and it would flash for a second, but I would watch them come down, and they would get about 300 or 400 feet above the ground, and they would kind of burst open, and then this white kind of fluffy stuff would fall to the ground. And people were starting to notice this in Phoenix, and a lot of people, there was a lot of videos out at the time that people were like picking it up with, like, you know, pens and stuff, and showing how thick it was. And one guy was, I think he sent it off to a lab, and it came back as like heavy metals and just a bunch of just like mold spores. That's when it came back as the human desiccated, human red blood cells was in it. Just a bunch
desiccated of red blood cells, yep.
Yeah.
Wow.
So, I mean, they're obviously, there's no medical purpose for them to be spraying this on us.
Well, they're blocking the sun to save us, don't you know?
Blocking the sun to, because we're all going to die of vitamin D.
According to Bill Gates, if you block the sun, you save everybody instead of.
It helps. It does. It helps.
We're saving you from the vitamin D poisoning.
Never mind the 30% reduction in crop yield, right?
Absolutely.
So you're going to cut back on the
really,
food
really,
by blocking
really
the
good
sun.
Job with these.
Kind of a no-brainer, right?
You do a really good job. We can get that population number down 10-15%, y'all.
We got to get that carbon number down to zero.
All right.
30%.
Got to get that carbon signature down to zero, y'all. Hey, excuse me, Mr. Gates. Excuse me, Mr. Gates. Did you just say you needed to get the carbon footprint down to zero? Yes, that's what I said, Lori. Mr. Gates, one follow-up question. Aren't humans carbon-based life forms? Next question. Ignore her. She's crazy.
Right. Another thing that was really important about this video, and it's still up for now, if you read the title, United States Air Force aiding the enemy in climate engineering programs, guilty of war crimes against Americans. And I mean, if we go just a little bit farther here past the pretty contrails, wink wink, we get to the meat and potatoes there. As he was tracking it, right there we go, no call sign. Which you have to be military to not have a call sign. And yeah.
Wow.
There you go.
Is that like a C-130? That's what it kind of looked like.
We could tell you if there were any call numbers on it, if there are any numbers whatsoever indicating what type of plane it was.
Yeah,
you can like the shape of it kind of looked like it.
Right. And that does not in any way, shape, or form mean we're calling out the entire U.S. Air Force. It's very, in fact, the U.S. Air Force may not even be aware of what's going on.
The government is so compartmentalized.
Most likely a drone.
It's so compartmentalized with this stuff that, you know, the only people that would know were the people that need to know.
There was somebody I talked to about this too a while back who was really, really knowledgeable on geoengineering and asking them what are the chances that, you know, a lot of these are drones. And
he
said the problem with that is because of the size plane they are, taking off in a drone really easy. It's the landing part of a plane that size that gives them difficulty. But to me, I mean, it would make sense that they're using drones, period, to do this.
My thing observation is, okay, you walk outside. I can walk outside in the morning at 8 o'clock, say goodbye to Dave, look up at the sky's beautiful blue, not a cloud in the sky, not one single chemtrail, contrail, whatever the frig you want to call it. And I can walk out 10 minutes later and there's 1,500 freaking lines in the sky. How does it get it? How do they do it so fast? Have you noticed that too?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
It's all automated.
It does. Yeah, I mean, it makes total sense that leads me to believe either this person didn't do enough research or was trying to divert from that, but who knows? But that would make most sense. He did make sense as far as, you know, having to, when you think of drones, generally you think of a plane that's smaller than a commercial plane, much smaller. So that would make sense. That the plane taking off would be the easy part. It's the landing part of something that big using, you know, drone technology. But like I said, we know as well as those other people who are awake and in the chat right now that they have the technology to do this easily.
Absolutely.
Easily. And they most likely are.
Considering that they're like probably 50, 100, 150 years ahead of what we know that they've got.
Right.
Absolutely.
Right.
Absolutely.
They have to slow up even the spread of how much technology they have to even people are participating. It's a deep rabbit hole, folks. Yep. And we're diving right down inside it like Alice. What's your dog's name?
That's Pistol Petey.
What up, Pistol Pete?
He wanted up. He was whining.
Hey, buddy. Hello, Pistol Pete. Is that a good girl or a good boy?
Aw.
Good girl or boy?
He's a good boy.
Well, he's a boy. Pretty boy.
Look at that. He is. He thinks he's all that, too. He'd get a good look.
I know, Pete. Oh, he's small, but I bet he's got an attitude. Hello, Pete.
Hello.
He's 100-pound Rottweiler.
Let's see what he does if I do this. Hello.
He just went.
You're scaring me. Stop.
He just snorted.
Dude, you're scaring me.
I love the inside jokes. It's funny because we do the inside jokes, then we just move right along to the topic we were on.
We just carry on with the inside joke and keep on going. Oh, Lord.
Well, how else should we move? Are we done with number one? Update part of number one and go on to number two? Or is there anything else we want to talk about in number one? I don't want to show too much because you can find it in the book.
Show it all. Show it all.
Yeah, but we'd be here till next week.
We're not shy.
We're going to do a one-month episode, folks, going through Jeff's 1-5 updates. And then we might get to 6.
Saturday night episode.
We might get to 6 at some point, which isn't as. So are you going to work on number 6 next? Is that where it's going to start off?
For the next
number 6 is impressive.
Sure. Sure.
Yeah, that's half a paperback, number 6 right there. I was over 100 pages on the digital end.
I know. I have 86 pages here, 6.
I don't have any time lately to work. I'm trying to get my freaking champion garden in order if we're going to allegedly run out of food here. I mean, I'm doubling up. I'm planting corn. I'm doubling up. So I plant 2 or 3 seeds in one hole for corn. I get into farming, gardening stuff. So if you plant 2 or 3 seeds of corn in one hole, it helps to support each other. Because I live in a windy area, too, a lot of the time. So I'm planting corn staggered. And then in between that, I'm putting freaking romaine lettuce and planting iceberg.
We're doing the same thing, man, as far as planting. Yes.
Yeah. I mean, this year, maximizing my shit.
Actually, we're not planting anything. I'm just counting on all the people dying and eating them. I'm good with that.
They're all contaminated with mRNA vaccine. Yeah.
When shit hits the fan, human meat, I'm all for it. Soil and green.
It's funny what that you guys are talking about that because this week was one of the first weeks we've got our downstairs. It's our basement's not finished, but there's an actual bedroom down there with a bathroom and everything. There's no window in it. And I asked him, I said, there's a bunch of stuff down there. Gonna start cleaning that out. I want to get some metal shelves and put them down there and, you know, make that because I said, if we run out of power, if it's in the winter time, we can't live in a house this big without any heat, but we could live in a room down there, you know?
Yeah.
So it's funny you should have mentioned that.
If you don't make it and I didn't plant a garden, I could eat you.
I got my cat. She's
you would have already eaten your cat if I was eating you.
My cat. No, I'm not going to eat you.
We're already past that.
No, Bella, I'm not going to eat you. She pops her head up like,
I would never eat animals. No. I would eat a polar.
Well, you don't want to. I can't. We've got a lot of Canadian geese around here. We've got a lot of birds and stuff. But did you guys hear about they're killing the chickens now because they have the bird FLU now. So got to be careful what we eat.
Are we allowed to say chicken?
I don't even know what we're allowed to say.
Absolutely. Red Pill Truth, man. I didn't realize you had a station. I checked it out. Good stuff, by the way.
Oh, he's got excellent stuff.
Yes, he does. Very, very, very.
Ken is on the ball over there. And cool. You know what?
Bring him on the show. What's he doing right now?
What's sad is he doesn't have a lot of. He doesn't get a lot of people over there that are missing out on the information.
I dropped the link in the chat. I dropped the link in the chat. If you know, anybody wants to join us, they can. If you're kind of ridiculous, then we'll roast you and then throw you off. If you're good at what you do, though, then, you know, hop on. Be good at it. But yeah, so I will bring up I got a number two, part two of the.
Whenever I bring people up, I always have.
I love it when a plan comes together.
Especially when we didn't make a plan to begin with.
Right.
That's it.
Yeah, when you bring somebody up.
That's six.
When you bring someone new up, you always have your finger on the button, though. Remember that. Remember that, Eric.
Here we go. Here's two.
Yeah, did we have a pornography scandal a couple, yes, 3 or 4 years ago?
Oh, yeah. Do you guys remember really that? Remember. Like in 2015 or 16, we were doing a live show and some dude came out and freaking started playing porn on the broadcast. And like I was scrambling to get it off.
And there was another channel recently.
That's probably when I learned about the delay, folks. And you can put a delay. You can actually put a delay on your video. So it automatically does that for that
now
reason.
There was a guy. I was on another video probably 6 months ago, a year ago. I don't even remember what channel it was, but he brought somebody up and the guy had his camera on. It was StreamYard and you saw it all. He had a mask on it, but you saw it all.
We caught it in time. Did not get a strike, believe it or not, but yeah, I remember that.
That's what they tried to do. They tried to get it shut down.
I mean, that's the quickest and easiest way. Now, YouTube and other streaming services, it's like an automatic 15 to 20 second delay. Like if you look at your phone and try to follow along in real time, you can. It's 20 seconds because of that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
But that stuff wasn't caught back then. Yep.
Nope.
We had a little waka waka waka. Yes, we
did. That's why I bring somebody new up, my finger's on that button. I don't care what you
do. Oh, so I think a few of these quotes probably would be great to read at the start of this is part two.
Yeah, I got a question for you guys. Is there a bunch of people sick around where you guys are at? Like where I'm at, there's like three different illnesses going on. None of COVID.
You sound congested. You know? Are you still sick?
Oh no, I've had the worst, one of the worst colds of my life last week.
You still
week
sound congested.
Oh, I'm way congested. It's probably moving into my lungs, but I don't know if they're releasing a bunch of viruses now trying to attack the people who got vaccinated or what's going on. But there's like my kids had a stomach virus like 3 weeks ago that I didn't get. And then I had to go do a job for a lady. She's like, I got a cold. Just got back from the South. I brought a cold home with me. I'm like, I don't worry about it. I'm taking all my, you know, my herbs and all my vitamins. Sure as shit, I freaking got it. And it's like one of the worst colds I've ever had in my life.
Yeah.
So I don't know if you guys know people are getting sick or not. But
well,
everybody's
January,
sick up here where I'm at.
Since January, I've had one of the variants. The first part of January, then I got shingles, and then I got a really bad cold. And I think I've been over the cold now 2 weeks and I still have the cough and I still have some.
Yes. The cough.
It's the cough. Yeah. The cough is just hanging on.
That cough is freaking deep. I've taken Mucinex religiously trying to break that shit up before it turns into pneumonia.
Yeah. It's the cough. That's
there's definitely some shit going around.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I mean, I could probably hack up a lung right now if I. But it's freaking deep down in there. You can feel it.
It is.
I'm taking
it. It is, and I'm supposed
asthma,
to go for. I'm supposed to go for.
It shouldn't. It shouldn't be
on my asthma.
It shouldn't be like this in this season. This is not the season for
it's
that.
Not.
That being said, you know, allergies.
Yeah. Well, I went to my doctor.
Asthma,
I'm supposed to be getting a test for my stomach, but they can't put the scope down if I have congestion in my lungs. So, you know, I went last week and she was like, no, you still got it right at the base, very bottom of your lungs. I can hear it. So it is deep. It's very deep.
My brother just got diagnosed with the spondylitis. What the hell? There had commercials for it. Like
respiratory diseases were off the chart. Previous,
a ton of these commercials for this stuff. Like
previous to this, guys. How many shows have you been with myself and talking about respiratory diseases are off the chart? And that was years ago, and they just kept climbing.
Yeah.
After COVID-19,
thank you for this.
It's up 75%.
Yeah.
And that number is probably low.
Yeah. Mm. All the numbers are low because they're holding them down. Can you imagine if we had the real numbers on the deaths from the vaccines? They're coming out. They're good. There's all these lawsuits progressing too. People are suing governments over this whole thing and laying out the whole case. Like the cobra venom guy has got his whole theory, but I mean, half or two thirds of what he's saying is exactly true, including calling out Fauci on the remdesivir trials in Africa. I mean, if you take remdesivir, you freaking die pretty much. And they're getting ready to introduce that to like 0 to 6 month babies or some crap. I don't know.
Unbelievable, right? Up, we lost Lori.
Oh yeah.
Oh Lori. What I noticed was as I was sharing this second part of your five status update, I actually did a like a spoken word thing about it, and they were your words, Lori. Oh, Lori. We don't know what to do if you're not here. We just start like banging our head into the wall and stuff.
Like the YouTube sensors cruising around like a shark right now. Like,
isn't it?
Got a hold of Lori. You're next. Then I'll be here all by myself like I was that one time. And all I'll do is play sound effects, right?
That was actually genius.
And then I'll be up to go.
Well, I mean,
second update, if we talk about that, was mainly about Bill Gates and Fauci.
Yeah, what I was trying to do was find
lost my internet. Thank you very much. Thank you. Please hold your applause. Please hold your applause.
No pictures, please.
Thank you. I'd like to thank the Academy. Lost my internet.
You know what I loved? I love that. You guys see that meme? Of course you did. With Obama and his wife. And his wife, Michelle, was the one who was saying, "Keep my dick out of your mouth."
No way. No.
Yeah, I think I've seen that.
There was also the variation where it went right along with it, where Obama's looking over. No, I can't. Right. And so Obama's saying to Michelle, "Keep my wife's dick out of your mouth." You see, I'm sure Sentinel's got all the good. Yeah, he got the cleeps. You want the freaking memes? Sentinel's got the memes. But yep.
Hey, it's the calling the man meme machine.
We know. You know, it's fun.
I don't see a good meme a day.
We never even talked about that whole thing, which we didn't really care. Staged, probably. Who really cares? I just wish I got it as much. I wish the Ghislaine Maxwell, can't make this shit up. Your name really is Ghislaine. trial got as much coverage as Johnny Depp or the smack heard around the world.
You know what? I'm having fun watching the Johnny Depp trial. Funny. Is actually pretty funny.
If you didn't know he was an Illuminati soldier, you'd enjoy it even more, wouldn't you? I would.
Well, yeah, but I mean, it's funny. He is the most sarcastic sarcastic asshole I've ever seen in my life. Just his facial expressions alone are just worth watching even 10 minutes of it.
And some of this.
Oh, you know, he's working that Jerry. Scripted
and trying to revive the actor. I mean, even your average Joe is not finding heroism in any actors or actresses anymore. They're starting to find out all this stuff about him. And where is that flight list, by the way? Are we allowed to talk about Epstein? Are we going to get a strike for that too? Why can we not get a list of those passengers? And why would it not be passed around media, mainstream media? Well, yeah, that's a loaded question.
Cutting our own freaking throat.
All right, talk about rhetorical. How about all these people on there? You know, another one of those memes. And memes matter because
they say something.
Matter.
You do, because you have Will Smith going, wow, that was a close one. I thought they were going to bring up the fact that I was on the Epstein's flight list, which is true.
Yes.
Not opinion. It's true. But we won't talk about that. Like, wouldn't that be more important to talk about that he was on a flight list for some freaking pedophile to go to his island? I'm going to Epstein's Island. Fuck out of here.
I have his unredacted book. Little black book.
I know. We went through it one night.
No, that was the one I found that was redacted. I've got the unredacted one that has all the phone numbers and everything on it still.
Ooh. Sounds like a ban.
It's last not week. Illegal, guys. I didn't dox him.
Let's do that show on my channel, then it doesn't matter. We get blown up.
Oh yeah, that's important. You do have
an open channel. Strikes over there.
Well, we're gonna get channel, probably booted from here. It's just a matter of time.
We can take care of that for you.
It's gonna happen.
Yeah, I bet.
We hope it doesn't, but it's gonna.
I don't need for anything else. I will.
So you can find us over at
Samaritan Sunday. That's why I'm not posting on my main Facebook account right now.
When we get booted, we're going to come over.
Keep my power dry.
And then you can get
booted. Yeah, we can go over there.
Well, then you'll get booted next. That too, because I don't get the cold. Yeah.
They'll let me out.
All right. Elon has been there. I'm just looking through the chat a little bit. All right, so we'll go back to this, and
I threw the link out on my Facebook pages. I don't know if
there we go.
If we get any bites or not? We taking our 1 hour break, didn't you?
Did we lose Eric?
Yeah, he like went robot and then he shut down.
Wow. I'm not the only one having problems tonight.
Usually I'm the one with problems with the satellite. I'm getting high speed internet in 3 months, I found out.
Woohoo! All right, woohoo.
For half the price. It's 200 bucks a month for crappy ass satellite cable where I'm at, and it'll be not even 100 bucks a month, I bet, for. To be plugged into the matrix. That's good though, because my kids are on all into the TikTok crap and all that shit.
Right on.
Which takes some bandwidth. They make TikToks.
I'm not seeing Elon Musk in the little black book, so I don't know about the flight logs, but I'm not seeing him in the little black book. Let's see if he's under Elon instead of Musk. Maybe they changed it a little bit. Elon, where are you? Elon. Nope, he's not under his Elon. He's not under his Musk. Let's see. Let's try this one. This because it. Hold on. Morrison. Nope. Not seeing him. I am not seeing him. Not saying that I'm not overlooking it, because there's, it's not in order. It's like some of it's in order, some of it's not. Some of it goes by country.
I've never ever heard either crimes. If he was on it, that probably would have came up, I would imagine, just because he's such a big name.
Eric, where are you? Can Eric come out to play?
Please.
Please come out to play. Come out, wherever you are.
Yeah, no shit.
So let me ask you something, Jeff. Have you ever thought of...
Yeah.
Have you ever thought of... Actually, no, it's not true. I was going to say, have you ever thought of reading your book out loud? But you have somebody on YouTube that has already read your first book out loud.
A couple people did. The one guy that did years ago, he only made it about, I think, half the way through, maybe two-thirds of the way through. And then he's like, it's too long, too much. And then I can't remember her name. Slower to Death, this chick did it. She lives in Puerto Rico. I can't remember her freaking name. We had her on the show, but she pulled them all off, and I've been meaning to get a hold of her to see what happened, if they started striking her account or what. Yeah. But I was wanted to tell her to put them back out there.
Yeah, I know that. I didn't hear about her. I know the guy that did it, but it was the first book. I didn't know I thought maybe he got through it all.
He made it like a half or two thirds of the way through, and then he kind of petered out. I think he's still around. But the one girl did a freaking outstanding job. I can't remember her name. She's freaking awesome. She took all the time to do it, and they took them off her channel or she took them off. But I'm gonna mean to try to get a hold of her and say, well, what the heck, what happened? But basically, it's the book on tape. You can listen to it for free on YouTube, which I turn a ton of people on to.
Yeah. Yeah, I that's what I started doing a couple years ago. I started listening to it at night while I was laying in bed. But I'm one of those people that I must be really suggestive, because I started having bad dreams about the book. So I had to stop listening to it before I went to sleep.
You don't know already, Lori. For sure.
No, I have to be careful what's on TV too. You know, I can't have the TV on a certain, if I have it on the news channel and I fall asleep, that's not good for me either. So.
Oh yeah. The power of suggestion. Totally.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. It's crazy. All right, Eric, where is he going? Let's get him.
They just blew up his channel straight up. We're due for a break. I need to go to the little boys' room for a couple minutes. Can we take like a fiver, Laurie?
Yeah, let's take a break. We won't have any music because he's running the controls. But let's take a break.
Take a quick fire. I will be right back. I promise.
Yeah, 10:06. Be back at 10:10.
I'll be.
American citizen is suspect under the Patriot Act. Cameras are everywhere. If you take the time to look around, you'll notice that I'm tracking everything you do. Just look up at the traffic signals. The next time you are in any decent sized town, A good deal, if not all, of these cameras are equipped with facial recognition and license plate reading software. These are not only monitoring, but recording everything that comes into the lens and stored just in case they need it. It costs next to nothing to store the information these days, as they are storing as much information as possible on you, John Q. Public. You're constantly pushed to stop using cash or checks and go with automatic debit to pay our bills. And on the other end, automatic credit for our paychecks, whereby we don't even hold in our hand the money we earn working honest day's labor. It's just numbers on a computer screen, y'all. All checked by Big Brother. Virtually your entire life has been recorded and is on a computer record somewhere. If you expect to be a combatant against the New World Order agenda, these records will be assembled together in the Homeland Security Office, and your case will be assigned to one of the HS lackeys to keep an eye on you. This means this person will be constantly reviewing everything you do, everything you buy, what websites you go to, where you drive your car, and what places you visit, looking for anything to build a case against you as a so-called domestic terrorist. If they feel they have enough evidence that you are a threat to the Great Plan agenda, and if you haven't fallen into one of their pitfalls, they will just flat out arrest you with no reason needed or given, send you to FEMA camp, or worse, Guantanamo Bay, probably never to be heard from again, and all legal under the NDAA signed by dear Obama at the end of 2011. We're also headed for a national ID card system with RFID location tracking chips. Once that's implemented and accepted by the sheeple, they will take it to the next level. Personal RFID microchipping, either by implantable microchip, RFID tattoo. With both these options in existence right now, COVID-19 contact tracing, y'all. RFID stands for Radio Frequency Identification. It allows you to be tracked by GPS anywhere on the planet. I'm not talking about injecting a small chip under your skin either. They can, in fact, do it now with an RFID tattoo. And if you don't believe this, you better Google it, because that's a fact, Jack. Be vigilant for false flag events concerning information security that can make RFID chipping mandatory.
I'm back. You guys back? Hello, hello, hello.
Hello, hello, hello.
So that it was interesting how entirely shitty that that came through. I like had Jeff's book lined up with one of those spoken word things I do, and it sounded bad. Did it sound bad out there? I could barely hear it. Am I wrong?
It was low.
It sucked, yeah. Man. It's like these come straight from reading from his books. Mm-hmm. Might add a little flavor every now and then. I gotta try that one more time in case you still have to get something done. Have to pee.
I keep losing internet, so I may be falling in and out now. I've been having this problem every night about this time. I don't know what's going on.
Yeah, you do.
No, I don't.
Is George Papard still there? Where's Mr. T?
There he is. There he is.
I pity the fool.
There he is. There he is.
I pity the fool.
So we're back.
That was the best show back in the mid-80s.
Wasn't it?
Greg, want to hear Lori rap?
I couldn't watch the movie version. It was a sacrilege.
Yep. Mm-hmm. She likes some of the French fried potatoes. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. No, you guys talk. I gotta play that over because I can't let that stand. What just happened there?
I just can't do it.
What did I miss?
On my board, it's oh my god. There we go.
Now Lori just got bounced out.
On my board, it came through freaking peachy keen. Peachy keen. Let's try it this way. All right, we're going to do it one more time. So reading your words, share screen. We got to share the audio. There we go. Let's try it that way. One more time. 5, 6, 7, 8.
9, 10.
11, 8, 9, 10. Sound better this time? I hope so.
Perfect.
Yeah. All right, let's see if we get the words up on the screen. Part two. Oh, that's not even the right, yeah.
Research I've done and continue to do, tips for others, and of course, praying my heart out. And I want to know what to say when the time comes for people to look to me for guidance. I woke up many thousands.
I don't know what the hell's going on. Lori's back though.
I know what's happening. Really see that with the system. We got this new world order moving out of each state, here is your time to look around. You'll notice that I'm tracking everything you do. Just look up at the traffic signals. The next time you are in any decent size town,
we're done with that.
A good deal.
Okay.
Yep. We give it a college try.
I don't know what's wrong with my modem. It keeps clicking off.
I don't know why there's. Everything that comes into the lens. I don't even know where that's playing from right now.
Next to nothing to store the information.
There we go. All right. Lori's back though.
For I don't know how long, my modem keeps shutting off.
Really?
Yeah.
Your modem keeps shutting down.
First world problems.
It's been doing it for a while. I think we need a new one, to tell you the truth.
It seems like you gotta get a new one every 2 or 3 years.
Who knows how long he's had. Well, he's had this one as long as I've been here. That's 7 years, so.
Oh, that's pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
I go about 3 years and then mine just blows up.
Yeah, and it shuts off. It's starting to piss me off.
God dang it. There she goes again.
Damn it.
God dang it.
Well, while we're waiting for her.
That's the end of the show, I
reckon. We'll see if we'll see if I can find it right.
See you next time, kids.
It's been great. Come back next week to win your
Lori should have books next week.
Oh, that's cool. That's really cool.
No, it's crazy. I can hold down the show. That was media, man.
That's how we met. I mean, you and I, that's how we started. It was you and I doing the show.
Fire the Sentinel. Back in the day.
But we miss you, Lori.
And here we are. We're still here. Dude, we got to get Robbie D on the show one of these nights. We'll ask Lori to invite Robbie.
What happened? You were freaking showing yourself. Now you're a white dot. There we go. There's Greg.
What's going on, brother? Greg? Well, look at those. Looks like the Terminator eyes right there. Yeah, shit.
Dun, 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 dun. Dun, 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 dun. I'm moving into a quiet zone here. I didn't hear my theme music, but that's okay.
Well, excuse me. There you go, my brother. Welcome, Greg Fernandez.
Good evening.
To the resistance.
I can't believe you had that ready for me. That's...
I didn't. I Googled it real quick. I got quick fingers, brother, just like you do. You got quick fingers and a quick.
That's what he said.
Stole my line. Come on.
Gotta be quick.
You gotta be quick. You are with the draw. That's also what she said. What's up, gentlemen? How are you guys, man? Always good to see you.
Good. What's up, Greg?
Oh, you know, another day in the life of
Dallas. Up and put a fast forever.
That's forever. That's Hot Greg, and that's his freaking intro music when Hot Greg comes on.
There it is.
No matter when you when he comes on, if he comes on your show, you better have it ready to play.
Yeah, you better have it synced up.
Greg Fernandez live.
That's all I came here for, is just to hear my theme music. That's all.
I think he's I think you're the only one that has your own theme music.
Good. I think that's how it should be. I think that's in my contract. I think it's in
the hell no, like I want some theme music too, man.
I do too.
Yeah. No fair.
It's all a conspiracy. It's because I'm white. That's what it is. That's what it really comes down to. As we all know, my white privilege kicks in all the time.
There it is. Yeah. I wasn't going to say it.
That's right.
Although you obviously aren't purebred white, although you're obviously.
No, white. I am.
It is.
100%. 100%. Yeah,
what does that even mean?
Fernandez is his wife's name.
Exactly. Right. Exactly. Right. I took her name.
Exactly. Don't let the black hair fool you.
No. That's all dyed. This is all fake. This is all fake. I'm like Trump. I just put some stuff on my face here. I'm really, really white, but you know, I just darkened my skin up here.
Fernandez is a traditionally white name.
It's actually Spanish, so yeah. Spanish is white.
You're a liar.
I would never, ever
Fernandez,
lie.
No.
Fernandez.
White.
Yes.
We can end this debate right now. Okay. Greg. Okay.
Yeah.
Greg, what does your mama make for Christmas?
She makes gingerbread cookies.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm and white. Nachos.
And nachos.
What's better than nachos and gingerbread cookies? I can't think of anything better.
He missed his cue. He was supposed to say tamales.
Yeah. Ah, tamales. For Christmas?
He leaves those for Santa.
What?
He bakes nachos for the kids.
If you're Amber Heard, you leave them for the guys.
He leaves tamales. Right. Tamales and a shot of tequila. Patron.
I don't leave anything for Santa.
Santa
doesn't.
Patron Silver, most. By the way,
Santa needs to get his own stuff here. Santa is not white.
You leave a worm for Santa, you're gonna get rich.
Awake veteran says, "Are you assuming the color of your skin? We're also assuming his sex, so we're calling him sir. So we are in complete faux pas today.
Yeah, you need to be careful about that too.
Be careful with that.
I will assume he's a man or a woman or the fringe 1% that's both. Other than that,
we could refer to you as they and them.
Okay, even though I'm one person, I guess that makes a lot of sense to me.
I refer to him as
that's
hot.
Never made sense to me at all.
Refer to
I don't
him
understand
like
that. I never hot understood Greg. That pronoun thing. Hot. Yeah, just call me hot Greg. I mean,
that's how you identify.
I mean, come on, check it out. Not cold Greg, but hot Greg. You guys have been talking about a lot of great topics again here tonight. I'm still waiting for my book, by the way. Still haven't received my book. So
you haven't, Greg?
Mm-mm. No.
Okay. Was I supposed to send or Lori? Which one of us sent it?
I got 1, 2, 3.
We've been sent out a ton. I'm almost positive.
Oh, I see. I'm pushed to the back of the line here.
Actually, we're waiting until the new book got released, so you can send you all three books.
Oh, okay.
It just got released today.
Okay, or, great. Well,
it got released to me today, but it got released. Yes. You haven't gotten books yet? What?
No. I mean, I've purchased my book, but not the book that I won last week. So I'm still waiting.
Well, I have your book.
So that's cool. Yeah. I got my book.
Yeah. I got your book.
Yeah, and you didn't even have to win a prize or anything for it, I think.
No, you might have to wait a little bit longer because Lori's got a shipment of books coming, so you can get all three.
Okay, that's cool. I can definitely wait for it.
I sent them to Spitfire and Lori, then
we have to get together and figure out who's supposed to send out books to who. And if anybody else hasn't received their book yet, let us know. You will be receiving one for sure.
And then where can people buy it right now if I just want to purchase it?
You can't buy the paperback. Oh, a private book seller could probably order it.
You're just talking about that Amazon. You're not. Tell him. I don't think you heard him. Tell him.
I don't know if they're carrying or not.
Why? What's going on?
Well, they deal with paperbacks and ebooks differently apparently. So like an ebook, they can eliminate, you know, immediately after whatever, but they want to like read, get a copy themselves and look through and make sure it's not like, or make sure it's professional to start with, which it is, and make sure it's probably not like extremist content. I'm going to imagine that they're
putting it on the platform.
Which it is.
I'm giving it a couple more weeks to even turn it up there, but yeah, I don't know. Who knows? I tried. If it flounders, I'll go on to something else, I guess. I don't know.
Yeah, I was gonna say maybe there's another company that maybe you could actually use that may not have the same issues that you're having with.
My printer prints it no problem because they don't read it. But so any independent book dealer can go to Lightning Source and order it because it's sold like seven or something through my book printer. So somehow it's getting out there. So I don't know. It just kind of got kicked out there. So it's, I'm more, focusing my energies on getting the third book of the main series going now. Just for, I don't know. Plus, I'm trying to get my garden going. I'm spending a lot of time on that. I don't know if I already said
I'll send you the company that I go through, and it may be worth it. They just, you know, as people purchase it, they print it out and they ship it off, and that's it. So you don't have to worry about anything.
Yeah, that's what I got to. It's through Ingram Lightning Source. They're a huge outfit.
Oh, okay.
I don't know. Right. I don't know who you're through.
I'm just worried about the whole censorship. The censorship that you're talking about bothers me. You know, that's not cool.
I mean, Amazon probably sells 99% of my books. So when Amazon says, when Bezos says no more right-wing extremist Q content, gotcha. It'll be off of there.
I mean, there's a that's crazy. But anyways, that I guess ties into everything happening now with this whole Twitter thing, which I'm sure everybody has like their own thoughts on it, you know, the good, bad and everything. And I don't know, I'm still weighing all of it. I'm really curious now to see what happens with Twitter, because now is the real test. We can talk about Musk. We can say he's good, he's bad, he's this or that. But let's see what he really does with Twitter. I'm very curious to see how all of this plays out. But I got on Truth Social, and I, you know, I wasn't really active on Twitter because I didn't really like the format. And Truth Social just kind of seems just like Twitter to me. It seems very similar. So I don't know.
Yeah, I've not got it. Is that Trump's deal, the Truth Social?
Yeah, yeah, Truth Social. I was waiting and waiting and waiting.
That's what I heard. Yeah, everybody's waiting to like get into it, and then so hopefully between True Social and Twitter, the commie socialists won't be able to start up a competing thing in there unless they just want to talk into an echo chamber. This is gonna get real interesting. What if Elon reinstates Trump? It's gonna freaking defeat. Some people are gonna lose their minds.
That's got to happen. That's got to happen. So funny. He's already
reinstated New York Post today, didn't he?
Yeah, I heard he reinstated a couple other people. That's right.
And he has some commentary on it. So maybe he'll bring Trump on and go, hey, this is the former freaking president of the United States of America. You can't shut this guy down.
Yeah. Yeah. They may wait because I guess there's
instigating a riot.
Well, I mean, because when in 2024 Trump's running, so he definitely I have a strong feeling he'll be back on by then. I think Trump was like Twitter. He used Twitter. I think that's why they went after him. I think Elon Musk, I was looking at that, he has over 85 million followers just on Twitter. That's crazy. I don't know. I don't really know that much about Twitter. I've been on there and I just never use it. I have no idea what to do with it. It just, I don't know. I really don't get it. So, but I'm there and I'm like, now I'm really, really curious about what's happening with Twitter and everything, and definitely how it's going to shape what Donald Trump does, because that was a big platform for him. And he was the greatest troll, I think, there. So I think the troll is coming back. I'm looking forward to it. I don't know if you ever watched any of Trump's speeches, but they're just some of the most entertaining thing that I've seen since.
Oh yeah,
since off the cuff,
teleprompter, just freaking going for it.
I would say some of Biden's speeches are some of the most entertaining things I've seen ever too. Where they does it, he turns around, he's shaking hands with nobody.
That was great.
Right. So, I mean, they're both entertaining in different ways.
Yeah.
One is pathetic.
Someone would have to really interpret Biden's speeches for me. I feel bad for the person who's standing there doing sign language where they have to like do the sign language for everything.
You almost Biden wish is. That COVID thing where they had the sign language person next to exactly. Every speech so you can understand. Of course, they wouldn't be 6 feet away, but I digress. God.
Yeah, how did the sign language...
6 feet away, the signer was like right next to him, almost hit him in the head.
But that's stay okay. 6 feet away. That's fine.
Sorry, it's a great topic.
How did they sign if they're wearing a mask? I never understood that either. Yeah. How do you properly interpret with the... Well, I know they use their hands, but don't they look at the mouth and all that?
Isn't normally,
that
but under free, protocols
yeah.
Of
totally, yeah.
Learned yeah. Elders of COVID. They don't use the mouth anymore.
Apparently not. There's a dirty joke in there somewhere. I'm not gonna comment. So.
Where did Lori go? Yes, there is. Lori, where'd you go? I see Lori in the chat. PM me, Rick. No, PM us.
Yeah, PMS? What's up with that, Lori?
I don't know. Bad joke. Lori!
Lori took off.
She did.
That's not cool.
Her motor was crashing.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Eric, I got a friend in the chat room, and we were talking about having you and Lori on at some point, too. We want to talk about the whole David Crowley thing.
Oh, for sure.
Continue what we were talking about last week. I got a Anytime, couple friends. Brother. Yeah, they have a couple questions for you guys and gals.
I know you had to ask to get clearance to allow me on, but
okay.
If they do, my handler talk to your handler.
Cool. All right.
My keep handler, my peeps will get in touch with your peeps.
Okay, cool.
And Lori's handlers, I mean peeps will get in touch with, yep. Dear people, and we'll make it happen.
I don't have people.
You don't have people?
No.
All right.
No, we don't have any handlers over here.
I'm the handler. No, I'm just kidding.
That's hey,
on the next episode of YouTube.
Just gave it away.
I know, right? On the next episode of YouTube Gossip, Lori admits on live.
You have no idea what you're in for coming on here with us right now, Greg, 2 weeks in a row. Telling you. Enjoy it.
It's fun.
I just can't wait to meet Mama Gamer.
Oh yeah, yeah, me too.
Mama Gamer.
Too. I'm looking forward
to the final
that,
boss. But...
The final boss.
Well, Greg was just talking about having us on to talk about David Crowley.
I would love to do that. Oh my god.
Yeah, I got a couple friends in the chat now, and I'm sure they have. I know one of them, maybe both of them, have a lot of questions for you, Laura.
Yeah,
about your dealings with the with the crime boss and all of their their little minions and everything.
I would love to talk to it. Sophia, and who's the other one?
Catherine.
Okay.
Yeah. Yep. They have a lot of questions for you about that.
I'm sure they do. Because you know what? Actually, I think Catherine.
That's who they called Hot Kathy, and so I was very jealous. So I had to change my name to Hot Gray.
Okay.
I'm not gonna let that slide. I mean,
no, I wouldn't let it slide either. You know, I think we all should be jealous of Catherine then, because you know none of us have videos like that made of us. We just, you know, how do you get one of them made, Eric?
I'm gonna go ahead and
what's your secret?
Lukewarm Spitfire.
Lukewarm spit water.
Lukewarm spit. Maybe. I'm a little bit lukewarm.
Yeah.
Is that your new stage name?
Yeah, we're still waiting for Eric's video here on that. I don't know. I feel like we should have played some of the videos last week. Uh oh. Yeah, well, it's nice, guys. I have my own fan club. I don't know about you guys, but that shows that I've made it. I don't even know if Jeff does. Jeff should. He's got four books out by now.
I'm trying to fly under the radar.
He doesn't have a fan club.
No.
Define fan.
We could change that. We could change that.
Define fan club. I have an enemy club. I have an enemy club, not a fan club, right?
Right.
That's what I call a fan club.
That's when you know you're doing a good. Like Eric's got a hate club. Jeff's got the hate club. I've got one. And now we find out that Greg has one too.
I have a love club. They love
this time when we have to have an inside joke. I got 50,000 gangs coming after me for 50,000 years.
I run with 12 gangs.
It's the whole world coming after me, man. They're everywhere. They're popping up here. I think one's popping up in my basement right now. Drilling through.
You got gangs within gangs up in here.
Who is that? Who's that Mexican drug lord that like would tunnel everywhere?
Chapo?
Chapo.
El Chapo. I think El Chapo's popping up in my basement right now.
It could happen. Never know.
Right.
Stranger things have happened.
Oh! There's pizza and chili! What's up, Pete? I'll be back. It was all LARP.
It was all LARP.
That brings back
the most of the chat rooms. Like, who the fuck is Pete Sanchilli?
You know, I don't know. To tell you the truth, Greg, I don't know if it brings back memories or if it brings back nightmares. Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Well, I'm sure. Hopefully, not too many.
Sophia says the Hot Greg fan club.
That's right.
Right.
Yeah, they all love me. They make videos about me.
Greg, let me give you a piece of advice. If you hang around us long enough, you'll have videos made about you, so you won't feel left out.
Say the Hot Greg fan club really, really like in your most seductive voice. Ready? Go.
The Hot Greg
fan club. Hot Greg fan club. Hot Greg fan club.
Yeah, get that.
Do we give them your only fan page?
Hot Greg.
Are we giving your only fan page?
I thought you had. I thought it was Mama Gamer.
Mama Gamer.
We'll get them a fans only page. We'll help you out.
I tried to join. They didn't let me in.
No,
I tried.
What?
No, you got to be hot in order to join.
With your freshly waxed ass, they wouldn't let you join.
No, man, they said you're lukewarm, Eric. You got to be hot. All right.
You got to work on that, Eric.
Yep, I'll go hit the weight room. Come back, get myself in a nice speedo. Make sure my ass.
Oh, you know what? I was laughing. I think Eric, your the show you did the show you did Friday or Saturday night with Scotty Too Hotty, or what was his name? Scotty the
you know what? That was just like a pre-recording of us talking back in the day.
That was so interesting. That was interesting.
That's an interesting fellow.
Yeah. Yeah. So you have a lot of that, I'm assuming. A lot of people come at you like that.
Yeah. Yeah, I got like it's pretty much every once every couple months I'll make a video like that now. Other than that,
yeah.
Yep.
Kind of over it, kind of done with it.
Yeah, but they are so funny. You got to give them, they're funny people, man.
Every once in a while, you got to give them the attention that they crave.
Right.
Yeah.
What am I, funny? Like a clown? How am I funny, huh? Huh?
Am I funny?
What am I, a clown to you?
Lori, why was there never a part two with the gamer's mama and all that? Was it just
because when I found out how vicious they were in the chat, basically, I really don't want to say this on air. They had lost the sight of talking about David Crowley, and they were after Jamie, you, Scott, and I wasn't going to be part of it. Simple as that.
I go through the broadcast we did with Greg. That's almost at 1,000 hits now. Where in the comment section they had a lot to say.
Yeah, there you go.
Have you gone through that comment section ever, Greg?
I don't think so. No.
Uh-uh. Oh, no kidding.
No.
Wow.
No.
Yeah, they.
We have about 20 minutes left. Let's go through it.
Yeah, they have a lot to say. You know, but I was not gonna give them a platform after they showed me how they felt about you and about Jamie and about Scott. And I didn't even know Scott.
Who's Scott? Who's
wasn't he the one that was on with Jamie that was from Australia too?
Oh,
Zadak?
Yeah. Oh, okay. Okay. I know what you're talking about. Okay. Oh, he was on there too. Okay. Yeah. I haven't seen their show either.
I was on the outs with Jamie at the time. We had not patched things up. We were still, you know, on the outs. Same with Eric. And, you know, I didn't want to be a part of that. I didn't want to open up that. I had no desire to attack anybody because of their difference of opinion on what had happened. You know, especially looking when you can sit there and just blatantly ignore the evidence that you brought to light and reading through David's journal and seeing his decline in his mental health. You know, I couldn't do it by my conscience. I said no. And it was set to go off. You can ask, I think Ken and Linda were in the chat. The link was up. We were set to go. It was going to be 1 o'clock. It was a Thursday afternoon. And I think I canceled it at like, I don't know, 11 o'clock in the morning. Told them to go kick rocks.
Wow. I think it got struck. Huh? I'm unable to find it. Yeah, it looks like I'm on strike till
it's a private.
June.
You
next
can
yeah, broadcast on the Sentinels of Truth is June, unless they strike another video.
They're going to strike you. Don't worry, Eric. They'll strike you down. You will become stronger than ever.
That's right.
Lori, that video that you sent me, I did watch it. It was a little painful, but I did leave a lot of comments in
you
there
did.
Too to kind of mm-hmm. yeah, because I was like, wait a minute, you guys have got so many things wrong here. Mm-hmm. Like, it was really interesting to hear what they were focusing on and what they weren't focusing on. I was like, wow, you guys, and it's just
totally
there's so much in there,
totally missing the whole point of everything. I mean, literally, you know, just.
And, You could tell that they were really, really lazy. They did not do any research. They did not actually look at any of those documents there. And that's why they always tell people, go look at the documents. Why? Because they haven't read them. Because if they have read them, they would know exactly what those documents say. And it would be very, very clear. They would have a whole different topic. But I do feel bad
if
there's anyone out there.
I think if they even read those documents, I think that just because of the feelings that they have for you, that they wouldn't change their mind. You know what? I don't believe that anything anybody can say to them is going to change their mind at this point.
Look what I found. Uh-oh. There it is. And you said they didn't come at me. They did. They came at me at this comment section for sure.
Oh, good. Well, finally.
Well, finally. Yeah. I mean, I prefer they come at me video-wise.
Look at the nutballs commenting. Yeah, there's Eric.
Yeah, I mean, about
there's
time.
A whole lot of comments about this that we did. There you go.
Yeah. Yeah.
Deep State Granny.
Greg is incapable of kicking anything. He's a coward. Wow.
Capable of kicking any? Who did I kick?
You know, it's a Greg is incapable of kicking anything. He's a coward.
Oh, I'm a coward.
So you don't look silly the next time you try to tell your fan club about DCOB, you can't have maggots without flies. And in December in Minnesota, there isn't a single fly. There is if it's a house is warm.
Correct.
Yeah, I've never talked about that though either. And that's partially what they do is they don't stay focused on what I'm talking about. If they're my fan club, they need to at least focus on what I say and then try to respond to what I'm saying there. That's mm-hmm. what's gonna make you part of my fan club if you want to be part of it. If you don't, that's a whole nother issue.
You've never seen this, Greg, because I mean
I haven't seen this stuff.
Swarmed by these people. This was 6 months ago. Yeah,
I mean, how could they have so much hatred for David Crowley, so much hatred for me, for someone that they don't know? It's not like they have the hatred for themselves. I feel like these are people that have, they really are hating themselves and are just
very happy people. Let's just put it that way.
Pretty much.
They don't really have too much going for them. And this is their 15 minutes of what they call, you know, they think that, you know, they're making a difference or having a say. And, you know, it's almost like they're using this high profile event to like try to get noticed. Let's just.
What does MBFT mean?
What?
Oh, I'm reading.
Inside the skull shows MBFT.
Yeah. Blunt force trauma. Okay. Multiple blunt force trauma.
And
yeah.
Mama Gamer here is claiming the final boss, once again, folks, is claiming that
that's what you said. Okay. That's what she said. That's what Catherine. That's what Hot Kathy said. I see. Yeah, okay. So it's hard to read because they're kind of out of order.
We could spend all night, probably the next 5 hours, going through how many comments came from these people here.
This was 6 months ago. No, I haven't seen any of this stuff. Let me
read. We were talking about a lot of things as we normally do, but
who was smoking a bowl here? Wait, because he's what I subbed because of my friend Greg. Thanks for helping spread the word that David Crowley did not kill his wife and daughter and then himself because he smoked a bowl. Yeah, I mean, like you were saying, Lori, it's the foot. And we had a commenter in the Justice for David Crowley and Family Facebook group the other day saying that it was a playlist. That's why David killed himself, based on his playlist. Now, the playlist, they couldn't even get the playlist name right. So, I mean, there's just so many things like that. And this
they're basing their opinion that he did this on his playlist?
Is this true?
That's right? what one of the commenters said. What does that say? Read it.
Read this.
Kind of.
He also called his own daughter a pink shit who ruined him and Kamala's lives and called her a sis. Oh, yeah.
He did? I never heard that.
Mama Gamer, she discussed
that. Did that happen, Greg? Was there
from the journals?
Journals.
Yeah, so, I mean, you have to read it in the full context.
His context, yes, exactly.
Yes, I mean, this is why you have to read the whole journal. See, they
like authenticated that he actually wrote this himself, too?
I definitely think.
You think he's under EMF attack? Was he under EMF attack?
I don't know. You know, that's been another theory too.
That was a big one, right? That's the big alternative theory.
That's the first one. I mean,
this did happen because
what happened to what's his name? Max.
Yeah, it's happened. Yeah, it'll happen to David.
I mean, it's just weird how they only take certain comments, but they never take the good comments that David talks positively about his daughter. They never take those. They never take the comments where David is saying, hey, this is how I really feel. And I know that it is wrong. And he, you know, is planning for his daughter's future. He's saying, you know, I need to work on myself. This is David's journal to himself. Mm-hmm. So this is him. I mean, to be that honest, That's very, very difficult. It's very difficult to put that stuff down on paper. It kind of shows he probably didn't have anybody that he could really talk to about that stuff.
Right.
And putting it down on paper, but then also working through it. This isn't like he was saying those things at the very end of his journal. And it's not, context is definitely key, but to even say, let's just say David did that, you know, hated his daughter. You still have to be able to prove that David shot his daughter. We're talking about a 5-year-old daughter. And this is what pisses me off about these people is that we are talking about a child that was murdered. Okay. This is not a game. This is not something where you take little bits and pieces and this and that, or where you hate Hot Greg, the master of your fan club, the desire of your dreams. You don't hate him over this stuff. What you really want to do, if you really care about this child, you would really look into the facts and you would focus on those, because if David did it, we need to know that and we need to call him out on that. And if he didn't do it, then there's a child killer out there and we need to find who that was. And so we got some big, big issues. That's one of my biggest issue with these people is just like, you guys are so disgusting because there is a child killer out there. Somebody murdered this child and you people don't care. You're more focused on me.
And hominem attacks. Right. I mean, look at this right here. Chat researching says the guy who doesn't know the difference between a name and a phrase, you forgot a period. Like, fucking, what relevance does that have to do with it, right? Said how many?
Yeah,
it's straw man attacks. They don't have anything, so they're going to go personal. Good. Look at this one. They're talking to Greg. You calling other people failures in life, but you live in your mother's basement. What does that have to do with the murder?
Okay, first of all, I do not live in my mother's basement. But even if I did, they would still be a much bigger failure than I would ever be, because they have failed in this case. Yeah. They have failed to prove David Crowley guilty. I have not. That's why I win. They lose. We know what the real truth is. David cannot be proven guilty. If people want to come and try to tell me that he's guilty, bring it, because you do not have any legs to stand on. And you are a disgusting human being to sit there and say that David Crowley is guilty based on a journal, because I got a punctuation wrong, because I live in my mom's basement. Make sure you get your facts right before you bring any of that stuff here, because all I'm going to bring you is facts on this case.
That's certainly,
and I'll bring it to you.
My mom would live in right here. I had forgotten
Nancy.
Yeah, let me.
Nancy in the chat, she says,
my mom's 83. I'm pretty sure she don't live in the, but I digress.
Nancy says, I remember Mama Gamer defending Freemasons when someone spoke against it in my chat. Yeah,
that's true.
The subject of Freemasonry did get brought up, and some of the people, Linda and Ken, and I think Deb, you know, started talking about Freemasonry, and she got quite offended that they thought it was,
she has family, I think, that are Freemasons, but I also think she had a family member that died, that committed a suicide or something like that too, or a murder, something like that too.
A little bit more freaking compassion.
Yeah. I mean, you know, it's just the whole thing. And look, if anyone knows where my mom lives, she would know there is no basement in her house, first of all. But I have not lived in my mom's.
She doesn't have a basement.
She has no basement.
I love my mom, a gamer. What in the body contains DNA? I don't know. Why don't you tell us?
What does it say?
You can watch any freaking CSI show and find out. But
she wants to know what in the body contains DNA. Everything?
Yep, just about everything.
What in the body contains DNA?
What is that?
I don't get it.
Yeah.
How about let's right?
We do not get any of
that. Okay. Well, yeah, this is like people that are like, they won't listen. They don't want to talk about the Bible unless I can quote it scripture for scripture or something like that. Yeah, then apparently I'm not a Christian if I haven't researched it.
Did Judy have that call up for 2 years before we put it out? Did she have the exact call that you put up?
The call, that was like 2016, I think, that we did that call. If that's what you're talking about, 3-hour call.
So actually, they should be saying that to me, not you. I titled it "Never Released Call," not Greg. So I mean, that anyway. I thought it was
never released.
I never heard it.
I wish therefore, I lived in Dom's days and I wouldn't have to freaking pay.
Listen, if I never heard it, it didn't exist.
It didn't exist. Do you have the DNA? Do you know what DNA is? Because DNA does not exist if you cannot prove what DNA is. I'll tell you what DNA is. DNA is what proves David didn't do it. That's what DNA is. So if you don't understand what DNA is, then I can understand why you think David Crowley is guilty, because you don't understand what DNA is. So why don't you learn what DNA is first?
No, can I ask you a serious question, Greg?
Of course, of course.
All right. So let's, everything aside, we know that he did not do this. So we still have a killer out there, first of all.
There's no evidence that David did this.
Yeah, okay. Correct. All right. So that leaves us to believe that there is definitely a killer or killers still out there. Do we have really any idea who would have done it? Because here's kind of what I'm looking at. If the deep state or whoever powers that be wanted him silenced, they're not going to send in some junky kid from down the block to commit these murders. They're going to send somebody in who, first off, is going to be to know how to do this and not get caught doing it. That's my first thought. And my second thought is, if this had something to do with the deep state, the police could and detectives could have been in on it too to cover it up. If you want to, I mean, seriously.
You had discussions with some of the police officers from that city, correct, Greg?
Yeah. Yeah. I spoke with Gummert and Dan Hinnan also spoke with Jim Gummert too. And, another officer, but you know, they really at some point, and you know, they were like, hey, we don't want to talk about this. We're not talking about it. And that was basically it. So they kind of shut everything down. And that was before we got the documents, before we got a lot of these documents. There are documents we got very recently that other people got that we should have gotten too. So now we're talking about major legal problems here. Because if these are public documents, everybody should get them. They should not be given to certain people who will hold them because they know it doesn't prove David guilty. There's a reason why these retards never put out David's journal, never made it public. The reason is because they know that it shows David did not do this.
Can't read it.
What does that say? FBI, FBI, CIA. You know, it's really interesting about all of those theories. But the reason why I don't really get too much into who would have or who could have, there could be a lot of different things. You know, yeah, a lot of different people could have done it. But it just seems like it needs to be drilled into certain people's heads that look, David did not do this. You still have a lot of people, mentally ill people, that are just going out there acting like David Crowley did this, and that's it. It's done. It's like, no. The burden of proof is on the accuser.
Right.
So I mean, that it's a great question. I think it's definitely something that, you know, we all need to look at privately. Put it up closer.
It's invisible, Eric. Ink.
Oh, it's invisible.
It's invisible. It's the invisible enemy. That's who did it.
Oh, my paper did it.
Now your video's coming, Eric.
Did not let it.
Right?
We figured it out. We figured you out. Not only did you do the David Crowley thing, you did 9/11.
Actually, if I had to choose any of them, it wouldn't be Mama Gay. It would be Judy. But I mean, I digress.
Yeah, I don't. I really don't think any of them. I don't think Judy. I don't think any of them have the brain cells to pull any
Thank
of
you.
That off.
Thank
they can't
you.
Even. They can't even get this right. I mean,
it's funny you should say that, because I've actually said those same words. Is that I didn't think anybody was smart enough to commit a murder. And it's funny you should say that, because
they're not even smart enough to look at the documents and to understand what the documents say. It makes absolutely no sense. If they were really smart, if they were actually in on it, I think they would be very, very silent. So I would look more towards the people that we never hear about, the people that we never know about, the people that are not mentioned in police reports, things like that.
I don't know if you're
those are really the ones.
With Lori, Greg might not even be hip to what occurred with you. If you want to give a quick,
I'm not hip to anything. I don't know.
There was a double murder in Lori's family not too long ago.
Yeah, there was a double. There was a active double homicide in my family. My
husband, I didn't know that.
Yeah, my husband's 88 and 80 year old father and stepmother were murdered in Clearwater, Florida, and this happened in September of 2018. And so we've
been going case right now. And
it is not a cold case. It is not a cold case.
That's the wrong word. My bad.
It is not a cold case. It is
Freudian slip.
It's an active and open investigation, and we
it's an open investigation, but the killers have not been found.
No, but we do
have had a field day.
We do have
coming after Lori about this.
Yeah, we do have a person of interest. I can't reveal too much, but I've been accused of blaming people on Facebook or on YouTube of committing the crimes. I've only said one thing about it, that I didn't think there was anybody smart enough on YouTube that could pull this off today. Okay.
That's true.
Yeah.
When does it become a cold case? Like, is it a certain amount of years?
I think it stops becoming a cold case, or starts becoming a cold case when they can't send any more information to the FBI. Like right now they can only send batches. They can only send a certain amount of data in batches to Quantico, to the FBI. And they've interviewed over 100 people. There's thousands of pieces of you know, information that they need to send. So as long as they're still sending information to Quantico and data is being fed back to them, it'll still remain an open case.
I think you should send more information to Greg, considering how, you know, he went through these photos of the Crowley case for that one, because there's some interesting things attached to her case. Number one, there was no sign of forced entry.
That we know of. The back door was unlocked, but that went out into the pool area.
That's interesting. You know. Just like the Crowley case. did the police say that there was no signs of forced entry or something, and that's why they think suicide?
There was no signs of forced entry. Nothing was taken from the house. Mm-hmm. They believe nothing was taken from the house.
No signs of a struggle.
No signs of a struggle, and they believe that the person that went there went with the intent to murder them.
And generally, if you follow, I'm a freak when it comes to like real crime stuff. Generally, 95% of the time, it points to somebody who they knew. So immediately the trolls, of course, ran with gotta be Lori. Right. Gotta be Lori.
Right.
So that's, I didn't know if you were aware of that.
I was not. No.
So the thing of it is, first off, I've never been in the house. And my DNA is on file through 1984 when I was going to join the military. So they have my DNA they have my fingerprints on file. They have that. In 2010,
isn't that convenient? You've never been in the house, so there'd be no DNA.
I've never been in the house. My husband's last time he was in the house was 8 years prior to this. So here's the thing is, this is what is in my mind about this case is the fact that they found no DNA out of the ordinary in the house. Okay, so that leads to one of two things. One, either the person that committed or persons that committed the crime has never gotten in trouble anymore and is not in the system. Or two, there's no DNA out of place there because it was somebody they knew. Somebody who was used to being in the house. And that would be family members, neighbors, stuff like that.
What I was always interested in is not to interrupt you, but everybody's got cameras. There's cameras everywhere now. If there was any, you know,
I don't believe there was any cameras at the house. There was cameras at the neighbor's.
On the neighbor's house.
They do have a person of interest. I can say that
on the streetlights. But I digressed. That's for another show.
They do have a person of interest in our cases. In this case,
well, that's good. That's good. At least they have that.
Yeah, and
at least they have that.
Yeah, and it's not me. Let me tell you, it is Christ. But it's been September of 2000.
Actually, you, Greg, you're the person.
it's this guy named Hot Greg. It's Hot Greg.
Hot Greg did it. Yeah.
You and Mama Gamer are the two top suspects.
Me and Mama, we were in on it, right? Yeah. part of our plan.
That's fascinating that they took something like that, a tragedy in Lori's life, and freaking, you know, the trolls used it to freaking point the finger at her somehow.
That's why I'm very cautious about pointing the finger at anybody.
Yes.
In this case, in the David Crowley case, first of all, it's going to take away from the real investigation that the police should still be doing, people should still be doing. Right. And so I'm very cautious about. I've always considered in the Crowley case or in any case that.
Well, with Lori's case, motive. What was the motive?
Yeah, motive.
There's no motive.
One. Yeah. Yeah.
In Crowley's case, there was a huge motive.
We won't find out. We won't find out the motive until we find out the person. I think
that's interesting. That's interesting. Hey, I'd be very curious to see how that plays out. I hope you're taking notes for a future book.
No, I.
That's what you guys do. We just talk. You guys do the books.
Greg, I'm in the private. And you're doing well. In the private chat, I just put the link. If you want to check it out.
Okay.
Yeah. So I have kind of an interest in this because of the fact that, you know, to me, I need my case to be solved. Yeah. And so I can feel for his family needing the case to be solved. It's almost like it's the first thing when you wake up in the morning, and the last thing you think of when you go to sleep at night is, what is tomorrow going to bring? Dave will call me on the phone and he'll be like, I got a surprise for you. And my mind immediately goes, he's going to tell me that it's over, you know?
Right.
You know,
that's so stressful.
And
so
stressful. And then you watch the anniversary come and go again. And, you know,
then you have her doing an online, you know, alternative media show with a bunch of trolls.
In my case, I'm kind of protected. These trolls don't really. I don't think they have the mental capacity to comprehend what they're doing. There's a federal law. It's called the Victims of Violent Crimes Act, and it's actually against federal law to use a violent crime to harass or to come after family members of that person. So because of the fact that I've been accused of it online. With no substantiations on that, and because of this federal law, when the crime does get solved, and I have every hope that it will. I know it will. Then after that, I already have an advocate.
You people dumb like, fucked up. You know you fucked up.
I already have an advocate.
You know that.
I already have an advocate through the Victims of Violent Crimes Act.
You know you dumb fucked up, right?
That's great, Lori.
And then once that happens and it gets solved, and it's, you know, obviously not me or my husband, then it can be taken further. And then it goes defamation, slander, and then the federal on top of that, the federal laws on top of that. So.
Wow.
Yeah, they done fucked up.
A whole lot of fuckery going on. We try to keep that off the show, but I did think it was very important for Lori to talk to you about that, Greg, considering
I do have a vested interest
you put into looking at the crime scene and looking at what went down there.
Yeah. I think that's why I took a vested interest in, you know, wanting to talk to Mama Gamer and Judy and them, because I thought, you know, well, maybe they can give me a different, maybe they could be a different perspective on it, because Greg, We met actually a few years ago before Eric and I had a falling out. You know, we had met and we had talked about all of this, you know, so I knew your side of it. I knew your stance on it. I knew about your books. I've been in your group. I understand that. So when I saw these people and I'm thinking, you know, maybe they're not getting a good shot. Maybe they're, you know, they need to be heard. Maybe they have some information that, you know, maybe Greg is just being closed-minded on this, you know? Well, when I found out it was the foot, it changed everything.
Well, Lori's always been open-minded enough to check out both sides.
You gotta check out.
Yeah,
and
that's what I got from that show. It did seem like you were trying to kind of be respectful, but really trying to push them on certain things to like, okay, guys, like what do we have here? Because obviously there should be more than just a foot, David's foot that matches his print. They were trying to convince
me of otherwise of what I had already taken my stand right from the get-go. I remember the day vividly when it was announced on Facebook that what had happened. And, being the conspiracy theorist back in 2014 and 15, I mean, that conspiracy pages and everything was huge on Facebook. Everybody took an instant grabbing of this, and we looked at everything. We were in group chats looking at everything, you know.
Interesting.
So I had already made my decision on this, knowing that he did not do this. I mean, we looked at everything. I can remember one of the things we looked at was the dog had taken, I think, bites out of the concrete or something over by one of the walls or something. I don't know. It had something to do with concrete. I don't remember.
The dog did everything but chew into its bag of dog food, but I don't know that.
And, you know, so when I went on with these people, my mind was already, there was no way they were going to sway me. I tried just to get them to maybe, you know, look at.
Sure.
They wanted nothing.
Yeah.
Right here, Linda, NW firefighter, prosecutors, police don't need motive in a crime. Correct. But it does help.
Yeah.
Having a motive definitely helps.
If the family would like to know the motive, you know, right. an 88-year-old woman and man who was loved by everybody, literally loved by everybody. And my father-in-law was an author as well. He had 3 books he wrote under different names.
Interesting.
So,
either there was a motive or could it have been an accident? Is that possible?
No. Another thing would be bodies. You've heard no body, no crime, but there's been plenty of cases where there was no body and they still proved the crime happened. So, yep. Great points.
Yeah,
I'd be interested to see. Yeah, I'd be interested to learn more about that case. Like what happened?
I'll send it over to you on Facebook. I'll do that. Okay. We can start. Yeah. This is the article that was one of the first articles that came out after it happened.
Yeah, can you, Lori, can you just kind of briefly give Greg an idea of what occurred to the victims? How they were murdered?
I don't know if I can, because I don't remember if it's been put out in the articles.
Okay.
So
yeah, if it's an ongoing investigation, it probably
I know a lot of things.
I can tell you what has been put out, obviously, because if I've seen it put out, then not from what you told me, but from what I've seen.
There's
a heart attack involved.
What?
There was a heart attack involved?
No. You're thinking of Wee Tree and her husband.
No. Oh, yes, I am. Correct.
Yeah. Yeah. You're thinking of Wee Tree and her husband. No. My in-laws it was definitely murder, both cases. Like I said, I don't remember. I would have to read the articles again to find out. But I can tell you in private, but I don't want to put it out publicly.
Right. Yeah. And I don't want to put out anything that happened in a different case.
Right.
Case was screwed up, right?
But yeah, you're right about the other one, heart attack. And
then that's another one. Another friend that we happen to be,
there was no foul play in that. What literally happened is one of them, we don't know which one. One of them had a heart attack. The other one got on the floor to help him.
Or it could have been a heart attack gun. We don't know.
No, it was heart attack. I'm pretty sure he had a heart attack and she got on the floor.
So the details of how your in-laws were murdered have not been put out yet.
I don't remember how much has. See, I know a lot more being the family. They've told us a lot.
That's interesting though. Mostly when people are murdered, they put out how they were murdered.
They may have. I don't remember, which is why I don't want to say.
Sure. No, I get that. Greg, would you agree? I mean, normally when there's a murder, they say how they were murdered, right?
I would say only if they consider the case closed. If they consider the case closed, they're gonna give the public a lot of, so they're obviously gonna give the fam, or they should give the family a lot of more.
You generally don't hear news headlines where they say that these people were murdered and that's it.
Okay, I just read.
So okay, well, with Crowley, that's all we got. It was a double murder suicide, and that's it.
Wrote Al Akbar and his
okay. So
blood I, and the blood of
that. I'm reading the first article.
They didn't even give us that.
I'm reading the first article. Right. It said Clearwater Police Friday said 88-year-old man and his 80-year-old woman shot and killed last weekend were targeted by a suspect.
Okay.
So I can tell you
they were shot. Yeah, I know. I remember in the article it said how they were murdered.
It's been a while since I've read the article. Sure. And since that time, we've had a lot of other information revealed to us. So I don't know what I can and can't say because
that's really smart.
I have to make sure that it's been put out in a newspaper article or in the public.
So they were shot. And I mean, that again, with the motive thing, that's very interesting. No forced entry.
Yeah. No.
Nothing stolen. That thing. And they were shot. Yeah.
And they're nothing, 80, 80, 80,
normally there's 80, a robbery 80. Or a forced
nothing
entry.
Nothing was that. Stolen that we know of.
That you know
I
of.
I would be curious to know why they say suspect and not possible multiple suspect. And that could just be the way that the news was informed about it, maybe too. So yeah, there's a lot of questions about that. That's pretty interesting.
That's pretty interesting.
Just on that right there, here, just for what they have
targeted.
See, they're targeted.
Mm-hmm.
And slain. I mean, that's the news. It's not. I mean, I really want to hear what the police.
That's interesting. You pointed that out, Greg. Was mm-hmm. targeted. Interesting.
Yeah. Clearwater Police Friday said.
For what?
At Elmina, David Swan were murdered inside their Flushing home. Police said Chief Dan Slaughter. He's no longer in charge of that, by the way. Said the police, the person that shot them, went to the home specifically to kill.
No kidding.
That's interesting, and that's coming directly from the police.
This was the one of the, this is October 5th, 2018, and we believe. I can't remember what day this. I think this was Thursday, so I believe that they were saying the time of death. They have a 24-hour window that's
pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
No that's motive, pretty good though.
Like, no, there's
generally.
No.
Well, got a mysterious love triangle. I mean, there's, you know what I mean? No motive, nothing stolen.
I can tell you that is right now the person of interest, we kind of would speculate the motive.
Do they know who was or have they released who was shot first, or do they have an idea of who was killed first
that
who
I
was
don't
killed
know.
Second?
That I okay. don't know.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
I guess if they anybody really can find out those details, it'd be you.
If they're going to release it, there's a lot of things they're keeping tight, you know, that they don't want.
Have
to
they released
that's what I mean.
The actual
Greg
autopsies
in the Crowley case released? That wasn't released.
No.
Correct,
Greg? No, yeah. Well, yeah. I mean,
you
yeah.
found a bunch of things that weren't officially released.
I didn't. No. No, they were given. They were given to me by concerned
citizens.
They
got to you, though.
They got to me. Yeah, sure.
I think we all, and that's, you, me, and Greg, and Lori, and Jeff, we find things that aren't released to the public. But this is, you know, very interesting. And I didn't mean to bring up a sore subject.
That's okay.
Lori, but the fact that Greg has looked into some of these things so much.
You know what? If Greg would be interested in looking at this and talking to me in private, I would be more than happy.
Yeah, he's really good at it too.
To share some things with you, and maybe you can just, you know, you mm-hmm. can look at it a little bit as a different, you know, with a different set of eyes.
Sure. Yeah. Okay. Absolutely.
Like she has to keep this completely.
I have to be careful what I say in public. Like
she hasn't even told me.
I understand.
It's been three. It's going to this year will be 4 years.
Right, and Lori, you haven't even told me who the person of interest is. So
no,
I mean that's how. But very interesting.
That's interesting that they say they were targeted, though. I mean, obviously it's they must have.
I didn't know
they have to have some type of a motive or some type of a theory and work.
Right. There isn't.
If you knew the person of interest, you would know the motive and you would know possibly what motivated.
Okay. Gotcha. Okay.
And I can tell you that in private.
Yeah. I mean, obviously if they've, who have they questioned how much time
everybody,
did they spend
they've questioned,
on it?
They have questioned over 100 people.
Well,
they
we'll know
swabs,
once the rest
they
is
look
made.
For,
Once they're arrested, we'll know.
Yeah.
Right.
Dad and Mino, they were very active. They walked all the time. They were very loved and liked and, you know, very respected. They were the type of people, they would open their home to anybody if anybody needed anything, you know. The thing of it was, is there was some workers in the area at the time. We don't know anything about that. Looking at it now, I don't think they've had anything to do with it. But I found the other day, and I'll have to find it again. There was a show on TV last year. And they released information that we didn't even have. And I gave it to Dave about a week ago. They said they have partial DNA. And the only reason why I could say that is because I found out about it through a YouTube video. And you want to know where I found the YouTube video? On one of my stalkers' Twitter.
I thought you were going to say that. Wow.
Yeah. I went over to check because, you know, somebody was saying she's still running her mouth over on Twitter. So I went over and checked it out, and it was scrolling. All of a sudden I saw this article or this link, and I clicked onto it and I started watching it. I screamed upstairs like, Dave, have you seen this? And he's like, no. And I sent it up to him, and we both sat there watching it going, what the hell?
Mm-hmm.
You know, so there was a lot of things that we didn't even know about that they apparently have partial DNA. So I have all the hope in the world that within the next year, this will be solved.
You would think no property, no robbery, no forced entry that we know of for sure. But with all these things ruled out, you would think the pool of suspects would be a pretty small pool.
It is. And I can also say, I can't say.
Can we rule out that? Can we absolutely rule out it wasn't some geeked out nutball who just stumbled into their place and shot him and got away? I mean,
with what I know, yes.
You've seen, okay. Well, right. Have you guys have heard about the case of the dude who freaking drank a bunch of chemicals, lost his mind, was having dinner with his parents, and stumbled along the road and ended up finding two people who are in their garage because they hang out in their, you know, yep. the story, hanging out in their
Absolutely.
Garage, and the dude ended up eating their faces off and did, right.
Yeah.
I mean, that's,
yeah.
But that guy got caught. You catch people like that. People like that don't take precautions to not get caught. So
yeah. This looks like a calculated something. Yeah.
It does.
Very calculated. That's interesting. Yeah. But I'm no very more, curious to know.
Nothing stolen, more. No forced entry.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Crazy, right?
Right. Well, I need to go. I have to be up at 2:00 to get my husband off to work. So.
Well, yeah, we're 20 minutes over how long we normally go either.
But. Excellent. Then if when you want to end it, I'll talk to you guys real quick, and then I'm gonna head to bed.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
Well, I guess we will end it with that complete F up. Look, I think I'm on like a revolutionary radio still. Can't swear that I did, but yeah, we'll end it with Jeff Hayes. Some words of wisdom from him. Any last words, Jeff? You haven't spoken in like 15, 20 minutes, man. Are you there?
He put in the private chat that he'd be right back.
So they got him.
The Illuminati.
Oh, he did. All right. We'll wait one or two more minutes. In between that, Lori, tell people where else they can find you, and you too, Greg, and how they can find your book.
You can find me over on Global Watchman News. You can find me on Facebook on Nothing to See Here Group and ESWG, Exposing Satanic World Government 2.0 is the page. And yeah. Terry's back.
And Greg, you, where can we find you? And where can we find your book?
Yeah, so I'm pretty much everywhere. If you just Google or search, don't Google, do a DuckDuckGo search for Greg Fernandez Jr. I'll probably pop up. And all of my books are on either my website, thegraystage.wordpress.com. truth.com or whatistruth911.wordpress.com. So that's where I post all of my content there. Anything that gets censored will all be posted there. And yeah, I'm not too hard to find. So I'm working on, like I said, I just finished the first draft of my Kyle Rittenhouse book, which I know in the future we're going to have a long talk about.
Really?
A long talk about that stuff. So
you say. So you myself and Lori are going to get together and talk about Penny Losner and other. Oh my God! Before that, we didn't give away a book yet, kids.
Oh, that's right.
We always give a question, and somebody wins a free book.
What's the question?
Yeah, Dad the Reb, not yet, Joe, not yet. who wants to formulate the question? You want me to do it again? Or you can do it. All we do is we take somebody's name and we take the first letters of their name and flip them around. Usually a crisis actor. Are we allowed to say that?
I don't know.
Guess we'll find out.
All right, I'll do it tonight.
What's the question?
It can be anything. What we do is we take the letters of a crisis actor, their first and last name, and flip their first letter of their name around. For instance, Penny Losner.
We did that last week.
Well, right, but we can do it with any crisis actor.
Hold on.
If you guess the first one to guess, it wins. Or we can do another one. You can guess Lori's height. It's got to be within centimeters, though. Size of Hot Greg's.
Go ahead, guess.
That's my length.
Oh, yeah.
Guess,
oh, yeah.
How tall am I?
Oh, my goodness. Yep. This is me sober. Imagine me not so sober. Anywho.
Catch him on Fridays, folks. Friday and Saturday.
We got to do a Saturday night show.
All right, I think Lori's got a question. Lori, what's the question? To win a book. Top six. Did he win? Wrong, because I met her and she's taller than me and I'm only 5'6" and a half.
Nope, not 5'6".
She's taller than that. It's a good guess, though.
Very good guess.
Although she might have been wearing heels. I don't remember.
I was wearing.
Oh.
I was going to say something, but I won't.
Hey, our viewers just shut up to 55.
That's funny.
We got 55 viewers now.
Maybe I'll.
They want to hear it.
5'9". No, I'm not 5'9".
Is it true? I dropped the towel.
He dropped the towel right in front of me.
Wow. We have it on record.
Yeah, that moment.
And the other person in the room took the video of it.
Yep. And let me tell you,
video.
It was so tiny. I'm taking supplements for that shit now. So now it's not as tiny. By the way, go to my OnlyFans page. You can see for only $25.99, you can get the penis pump. You can make it. Yeah. Oh, what were we talking about?
I'll be right back. I have to leave for a second. I put my height over in the private chat in case somebody gets it.
What is it? What's the question?
Her height. Right?
Oh, that's it. Oh, that is all right. 5'9".
That is the question.
Six foot. Good guess. If this. We can make it like the Price is Right. The person who gets closest.
Six feet and one penny.
6'1".
6 feet and one penny.
Yep, you fed. Ernie, beware, you win. She is an actual Amazon.
6'1".
And she dunks.
7'2".
And dunks.
Lori, nobody else? Come on, man. There's not many in between there. We're only missing a couple. Are we missing any? Oh, we are. 5'4"? Lori? No? Yes. Lori Beeler?
I think she's coming back.
She's like, let me give the question. Then I answer. I'm like, fucking every height from 4 foot five to 10 feet is coming in the chat room. Lori?
Hello? Well, she said she put it in the private chat.
Oh. 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 Somebody, I think somebody probably already got it. I'd be shocked if they didn't. But like, see if somebody got it. Yep, right there when Bill Truth got it.
All right, I'm back.
There it is.
You got it. All right.
Oh, what were you? You're like, I wonder when they're going to look at the chat.
As soon as she comes back.
5 foot,
five foot seven.
Wasn't that like a, wait, who was that? It was Too Short. Remember Too Short? 5 foot seven with a five, wait, it was 5 foot seven with a 7 foot dick. Remember that? Too Short? No.
Was that Too Short?
Black one in the chat.
So Ken got it. So I'm going to put Ken.
And I'm the only white one.
Oh, it was 5 foot seven with a 10 foot dick. That's what it was. 5 foot seven with a 10 foot dick. I'm too short. So I'm walking on the street and I had to stop, turn up the radio, and drop the top. Remember Too Short?
5 foot seven it is. I am 5 foot seven. Well, I was.
Without a 10 foot.
Hey, now.
What, are you questioning your pronouns?
It's all Eric. Just blame Eric for it.
He's questioning your pronouns.
I think next week we should have Greg and Sophia on and talk about nothing but Crowley.
Let's do it. Let's do it.
Can we talk about the New World Order a little bit?
We have to.
Oh, that's all part, right? That's all part
of it. Actually, you know what? I might not be here next week. We are planning a trip to Shreveport to visit. We have a relative who has Alzheimer's who's not doing very well. So I think he wants to go next week, but I'll let you know.
Oh, cool.
Okie dokie.
All right. Well, I'm going to take you out with what I tried to do during the break very poorly. We'll see if it comes through better this time. We'll see you next week. Same place, same time. Live on Rise of the New World Order. Welcome to the Resistance. Peace.
Peace.
Yo, nearly every American citizen is suspect under the Patriot Act. Cameras are everywhere. Take the time to look around. You'll notice that I'm tracking everything you do. Just look up at the traffic signals. The next time you are in any decent sized town, a good deal if not all of these cameras are equipped with facial recognition and license plate reading software.